Demand curves are used to estimate the impact that changes in price have on consumers' willingness to purchase a product or service. Tonight, we're going to learn how to fit the two most popular types of demand curves, linear and power, using Excel in real-world marketing situations. Basically, a demand curve tells us the number of units customers will purchase, or demand, at every possible price point. This is a completely made-up demand curve for a fictional product, Widget X. The curve implies that if we charge $10 for Widget X, we can expect to sell 1,000 units. If we charge $15 for Widget X, we can expect to sell 750 units. We're interested in using these curves to come up with a pretty good estimate of the best price we should charge, one that maximizes our profit margin for a particular good or service. It's worth emphasizing that the best price is one that maximizes our profit margins. It's not necessarily the price that results in the most units of product being sold. For example, Starbucks would rather sell 12 cups of coffee for $5 each than 50 cups of coffee for $1 each. To estimate that best price, we need two things: our cost to produce the product to be sold, and the product's demand curve. So for a precise definition, let's say our variable cost to produce one unit of a product is the cost of good, or COG. Recall that a demand curve represents how many units of a product customers will purchase from us at every given price point. So if we charge P dollars per unit, the demand curve will give us a corresponding number, DP. DP is the number of units that we can sell to customers at the price P. Once we know our unit cost and have our demand curve built, the profit margin for a particular price is the profit margin per unit at that price, which is the price minus the cost of producing a product, multiplied by the number of units we can sell at that price. Despite what I might accidentally imply tonight, keep in mind that demand curves aren't set in stone. Competitive pressures, customer sentiment, and macroeconomic factors guarantee that they're very dynamic and subject to constant change. Let's take a quick second to review price elasticity. When we're talking about demand in a marketing context, price elasticity measures how much demand decreases if you raise prices by 1%. We consider a product to be price elastic if its elasticity is greater than 1. If a product is price elastic, it means cutting the price will increase revenue. A product is considered price inelastic if it has an elasticity less than 1. Cutting the price of a price inelastic product will decrease your revenue. The economists over on the other side of campus spend a lot of time studying the price elasticity of all sorts of products and services. Just for illustration purposes, here's a couple of elasticity estimates for common products and services in the Boston metropolitan statistical area. So these values imply that if every restaurant in Boston cut their prices by 1%, they'd see a 2.9% increase in demand by diners. If you're trying to set the prices for your company's products, you have to understand your product's price elasticity to make wise decisions. We're going to use a product's price elasticity to construct an estimation of its demand curve. There are several different flavors of demand curves, but we're going to explore the two most popular tonight: linear demand curves and power demand curves. Linear demand curves depict a straight line relationship between a product's price and customer demand. Mathematically, the relationship is represented by this formula. D is the number of product units demanded by customers, and P is the price we charge per unit of product. A and B adjust the curve, and we're going to get Excel to automatically calculate those values for us. Power demand curves are arcs that depict the change in relationship between price and demand when a product's elasticity isn't affected by price. This is the generic form of the exponential formula that describes a power demand curve. As before, D represents demand and P represents unit price. A and B continue to be used to adjust the curve to match the product's price elasticity, but there's a slight twist for B. It's actually the additive inverse of the product's price elasticity. So if a product's elasticity is 2, B would have a value of negative 2. Again, we're going to let Excel handle the calculation of A for us. So what's the big differentiator we can use to decide between the two types of demand curve? It's the product's price elasticity. If the product's price elasticity changes when the price changes, we need to use a linear demand curve. If the product's elasticity remains constant regardless of price, we need to use a power demand curve. So let's start by constructing a linear demand curve. Let's pretend we work for Ralph Lauren and we're selling polo shirts for $90. At the current price, demand is 1,000 units, and price elasticity is 2. Basic geometric theory tells us that to construct a linear curve, we need to know at least 2 points on the line. And we already know 1 point, since we know that when the price P is $90, demand D is 1,000 units. And since we know the price elasticity of polo shirts at $90 is 2, we can pretty easily calculate our second point. Using the definition of price elasticity, we know that if we increase the price of our polo shirts by 1%, or 90 cents, demand will decrease by 2%, which is about 20 shirts. So our second point on the line is at price P equal to $90.90, and demand D equal to 980 shirts. So let's enter our 2 points into an Excel worksheet. Now, let's create a scatter chart of the 2 points. Select the data fields, then navigate to the Insert tab, click the Scatter option in the Charts group, and choose Scatter with Only Markers. Notice that the chart makes it look like our demand curve is sloping upwards. That implies that demand increases as we increase price. That's obviously not right. Excel is assuming that our points are arranged in columns rather than rows. To fix it, click the Switch Row Column icon on the ribbon. Now, our scatter chart slopes correctly. Our next step is to get Excel to draw the demand curve for us based on the data points. It'll automatically calculate the values for A and B for us as part of that operation. Right-click either of the data points in the chart and choose Add Trend Line from the context menu. In the Format Trend Line dialog, choose the Linear Radio button and check the Display Equation on Chart checkbox. Then, click the Close button. Excel gives us the plot of the line connecting our 2 points, along with the equation for the line. Because we're graphing unit price on the X dimension and customer demand on the Y axis, our value for A is going to be 3,000, and our value for B is going to be approximately 22.2. If we plug those values back into the linear demand curve equation, we're going to get this formula. In plain English, the formula tells us that for every 90 cent increase in the price of the polo shirts, we're going to lose demand for a little over 22 shirts. A key thing to keep in mind when you're working with linear demand curves is that they are estimations. They're spot on near the current price point, but the further you go up or down the line, the more inaccurate they're going to get. Within about 5 percentage points either way of the current price, you can treat them as a pretty good approximation of the product's true demand curve. For linear demand curves, we operate under the assumption that price elasticity changes a bit as the price changes. That's a pretty reasonable assumption for lots of products. But if you know that your product's price elasticity stays constant, regardless of unit price, then you need to use a power demand curve. So let's use our same sample situation. We're working for Ralph Lauren, and we know that demand for our polo shirts is 1,000 units at the current price of $90. Again, let's say that the price elasticity for our shirts is 2, but this time we know for a fact that the elasticity stays at 2, regardless of what we do with the price per shirt. We can use Excel's goalseek functionality to easily calculate the value of A in our power demand curve equation. We don't really have any idea what A's value is going to be, but we can give Excel a wild guess to get it started. So let's open a new Excel worksheet and enter the value 1 million as a starting guess for the value of A. Next, we're going to enter our current unit price of $90. So, recall from a few slides ago that the power demand curve formula looks like this. Let's set the value in our demand cell to be that formula. And then we'll accept the formula. And you'll notice that the demand value is pretty far off from the value of 1,000 that it should be. That's because our wild guess about the value of A is also pretty far off. But no worries. We're going to let Excel's goalseek function fix everything for us. Basically, goalseek changes the value of a variable in a formula until the formula has the desired result. We want goalseek to find the value of A that makes our power demand curve match up with our known demand for 1,000 polo shirts when the price is $90. So start goalseek by navigating to the Data tab in the Excel ribbon, choosing What If Analysis from the Data Tools group, and clicking on goalseek. We want to set the cell containing our customer demand to 1,000 by changing the value of the variable A in our formula. Alright, so click the OK button and goalseek will sip off. When it's done working, it'll put the correct value for A in the worksheet and show us the summary dialog. And then we can click OK button to dismiss that summary dialog. Now that we have the correct value for A, we can generate several points on our demand curve, and then we can chart them to see what the curve looks like visually. So create a small data table in your worksheet, let's say 4 demand and price points on either side of our starting point in $10 increments. Enter prices between $50 and $140 in the price column of our data table. Now, enter the power demand curve formula using our calculated value of A for the first cell in the demand column of our data table. Copy that cell, Excel's actually copying the formula, then paste it as a formula into the remaining cells in the demand column of our data table. You verify everything's correct by looking at the point we know the value for. Demand should be 1,000 shirts when the price per shirt is $90. Now, select all of the cells in the data table, navigate to the Insert tab, click the Scatter option in the Charts group, and choose Scatter with only markers. A chart of the points on our data table will appear. We can have Excel draw a smooth power curve for us. To do that, just right-click on any of the data pointers in the chart and choose the Add Trendline option. In the Format Trendline dialog, select the Power Radio button, then click the Close button. And Excel will draw the power demand curve on our chart. So now that we've established a correct value for A, we can plug it back into our formula for our power demand curve. And for any price on the curve described by this formula, the price elasticity of demand remains constant at 2.